Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
You guys look super cozy. I'm a little jealous.
I am very cozy.
We're on Savannah's big comfy couch.
So wait, you're at Savannah's house in Nashville?
Yes.
So when did you guys get there?
To Nashville or to Savannah's house?
I don't know how long have I been here.
You must be going nuts. All right. So anyways, introduce yourselves because it's Sammy, Sam, and Savannah, right?
Yes. I'm Sammy.
I'm Sam.
And I'm Savannah.
We all sound the same and have very similar names, so don't stress out about getting it right.
Awesome. So I love this song. I mean, it's incredible, so we're going to talk about that. But I want to hear the journey, because this is crazy. It's been just a couple weeks since you actually officially released the song. But like a while ago, even before that, you had all of these famous people like kind of picking up on it and doing it on TikTok. So like, can you guys tell me like where this song began?
One day
I was having, I mean, I guess I had the worst week of my life. And then there was a day where Sam called me and told me that Sammy's cat Gumbo had died just randomly one night. And I was like, this is honestly outrageous and whack. What else can happen in this year? And I was like, I need to do something. Like, the way I get my emotions out is just write a song about it. So I went up on the mic and freestyled, and the first verse and chorus came out.
And then we just threw it up on TikTok.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, we all discussed, and we're like, this is dope. Like, it should live somewhere, and our team's never going to let us put it out because she said 2020 like a million times. So, like, we just put it up on TikTok, and then we put it up that night, and then we woke up the next morning, and it had, like, 4.5 million views, and we're like,
Whoa,
maybe we should finish the song because people actually want to hear it.
For sure. I mean, listen, I heard it and I go, oh my God, they're speaking to me right now. Like, this is life.
It's so crazy. Yeah.
I'm happy you relate, but I'm also very sorry. So sorry that you're relating to it.
Well, I mean, I think the world is going to relate to it because all of us have, like, you know, there's never... I think the biggest part is the people that are going to thrive right now are the ones that like always look at their glass half full, or you know what I mean? Like, so it's going to be a lot of people around the world who are just getting torn down every single day who are going to hear this song and be like, okay, all right, I'm not alone. Forget this year, you know, all that. And I actually, so of course we're playing the edited version on the radio, which is totally fine. But when I'm in the car, you better believe I'm screaming.
Oh, yes, you are, yes, yes.
So I love it. All right, so a little bit more personal. How is, like, I think this is going for everybody, and maybe I'm asking because I'm in desperate need, but like, how do we date during this time? And do we date during this time?
Listen, dating during the quarantine is so dangerous because you're like, do I like you or am I lonely and sad during this time?
Yes.
Yep.
Exactly.
You know, it's so hard to tell.
Also, we were bad at dating before this. Yeah.
So like, there's no hope. I'm very proud to say, like, a week or two into quarantine, I deleted all my dating apps. I was just
what are you gonna do? Go on a quarantine date?
Like, I tried and I didn't like it. I gave up on it really quick, and I have been a lot less stressed ever since.
I did like a Zoom date or two, but ooh. I think you're right though. I think it comes down to a lot more people are thirsty right now. And so like
thirsty, the date- he says. Thirsty.
There's just nothing else to do or think about or fixate on, so you're like,
right. And I like to talk over people in a date because I have a lot to say. So there's a lot of talking over them.
it's not your fault that they're not as interested as you. Honestly, you got more to talk about.
Right. I mean, exactly. Look how cool my job is.
Exactly. You know? So, bingo.
Done. All right. So here's like kind of the tough part position that you're in. So now you got a hit song during a quarantine, during a pandemic, and you can't go out and meet your fans, perform it live, do any of that. Mm-mm. So like, what are you going to do to like really get this out there? Obviously it's out there on social media. Obviously mm-hmm. people are seeing it on TikTok. We're playing it on the radio, but like, are there any like Jimmy Fallon in the works? Is there any of that kind of stuff in talks right now?
I think that's a goal. Yeah. I don't know. This is what happens in our career. We kind of just chill and then our team will be like, yo, this is happening. And then we'll be like, dope. So we just chill until something comes our way, and then
I guess our main like plan of action right now is just like keep writing more, keep making more content, connect with all the new people who now know who we are and like want to talk to us. And so
maybe we should do like a Zoom party or something.
Yes.
Ooh, I like that idea.
I'm there. I want an invite. Thank you.
You're invited. You're the host. You're the host.
Oh, hell yeah. I've got the tequila. We're good to go.
Ooh, there we go. There we go.
Oh, darn. So I think that at the end of the year, hopefully we can get ourselves back on the road. Is there like someone that you'd like to go on tour with or collaborate with that is like a dream?
My big dream is Kacey Musgraves and or Harry Styles.
And or, yes. Yes.
Or yes. Billie Eilish.
That, yeah. We're aiming really big right now.
We aim too big.
No, not too big. Just very big.
You gotta dream big. It's fine.
Okay, we're dreaming it out there. We're putting it out.
I love it.
I feel like Billy wouldn't let us on tour because my hair is also green.
She'd tell you have to change it for a moment.
I'd do it for Billy. Yeah, I'd change it for Billy.
Yeah.
She wants me to be brunette. Fine.
So, out of the group, who is the most controlling or who's the biggest neat freak?
Those are different.
Yeah, those are different.
Most controlling? You love to be in control, though.
But
you're a sneaky controller.
She's a manipulator. She's a manipulator.
Listen, she is a Slytherin. She is a Slytherin.
That's not controlling, but manipulator.
I love that.
I'm the queen boy.
Sammy's the only one that does dishes.
Oh.
You don't know my life.
Yeah, you don't
do. I've lived with you for 4 years. You don't do dishes.
Yeah, they're in my seat right now.
I love it. You guys are so much fun.
You're so much fun.
I know. I like.
I wish we could hang out in real life and get drunk.
I'm having a bad hair day, but like I feel like we all have a bad hair day every day.
What do you mean? It's doing a very nice swoopy thing.
It's
a really nice little wave.
It's kind of humid here, so it's flat and not, I like my hair high, like a Southern Belle. I like my hair closer to God.
Have the hair closer to God.
Exactly. Have you guys, I know you're not supposed to, but have you guys gone out in like Nashville at all or had a chance to like do anything?
No.
I mean, like, really. Walmart for necessities. But mask on, hand sanitizer at the ready. If right now the things that I have to do are like get takeout and stay at home and watch Netflix to better society, done. I'm doing it.
Love it. So one last question, and you can be honest. You guys look very naturally beautiful, right? Are there any, right? I mean, like, you guys look amazing. You don't have any makeup on, am I right?
None whatsoever. Absolutely nothing on my face.
But if you could choose like a makeup line that like, say they wanted to like represent you or you want to represent them, who would you pick?
Oh gosh.
Keep in mind that there's a beauty line coming out from a big artist.
Oh, Selena's Bear. Oh man.
Wait, what is that?
Selena Gomez has a new cosmetic line.
Hello.
Really?
But then there's
I want Selena's makeup collection.
I would do that mixed with like MAC because they have like all the colors that you could do Euphoria makeup with.
Ooh.
And like all the jewels and the glittery stuff.
The other day.
Or, oh my God, there's so many. I just went to Ulta the other day and was like,
I did not know she's coming out with the makeup.
Now I want to Google it.
Yeah.
You've been living under a rock.
Yes,
I'm sorry. I literally have. I just stay at home and watch Netflix and play GTA.
I love it. Before I let you go, and if I'm putting you on the spot, you can totally deny me, and it's totally fine. Can I hear any like harmonies from you guys?
Ooh, yeah.
Ooh.
Just
like
a little chorus of.
A little bit.
Oh, is that what you're thinking of?
Oh, no, wait.
Oh.
I was going to say goodbye.
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 Ooh. Bye. Yes. Awesome, guys. Thank you so much. Avenue Beat, you guys are amazing.
Oh, thank you so much. This is so fun. Thank you so much. Love you.
Bye. Bye.